All right, well, maybe you're looking for the perfect stocking stuffer, or maybe you're looking for the perfect book to get into over the holidays. No matter what you're searching for, Rainy Day Books has it on their shelves.
We're having a lot of fun this holiday season because people come in with their lists, and then we do matchmaking so that their friends and family and they are happy with the results. So if you're interested in fiction, top mystery in the country, Louise Penny's Kingdom of the Blind. We have Inspector Gamache back in the little town of Three Pines in Canada. And the question is, her theme, what is the nature of evil? Does evil exist? And if you try to combat evil, how far can you go before you're drawn into the dark side? The Collector's Apprentice by B.A. Shapiro is an art mystery. Shapiro is the top art thriller writer in the world. It takes place in 1920s Paris, and Matisse is a character in it. Then two wonderful novels that take place in small towns. The Night of Miracles by Elizabeth Berg takes place in a small town in Missouri. Virgil Wander by Leif Inger is the upper Midwest. And they're both about people these days have a lot of challenges, but if you have a sense of community and people help each other, everything will be okay. A lot of great heart in these books. And then historical novels, The Well-Behaved Woman, is a story of the Vanderbilts in the Gilded Age in New York as they rise to power. And then House of Gold by Natasha Solomon, it's a fictional story about the Rothschilds, the five branches of the Rothschild family, as World War II is coming in Europe. Then if you want a thriller, The Banker's Wife is an international thriller where a couple takes off in a plane, and the plane supposedly crashes in the Swiss Alps. And then it's really about what the Swiss bankers are probably up to internationally. And then Vox is an interesting perspective on something like The Handmaid's Tale, because it's a situation in the future where women have to wear a bracelet. If they say more than 100 words a day, then they're shocked and they're not allowed to work. Very interesting. Then in nonfiction, Doris Kearns Goodwin's new book, The Leadership in Turbulent Times, is about the two Roosevelts, Lincoln and LBJ, whom she worked for. And she is such a fantastic storyteller. So it's history, but it's not at all dry. You even get a perspective on Lincoln's handshaking as he signs the Gettysburg Address. And then Presidents of War of Michael Beschloss is about the presidents who handled entering and exiting war from 1812 to the Vietnam War. Then The Capitalism in America is the new book by A History of Capitalism by Alan Greenspan. The Escape Artists is the story of the greatest escape of World War I by Neil Bascom. American Dialogue is the new book by Joseph Ellis, the very famous historian. And he asked the question, what would the founders think about what's going on now? Then, if you have a sports fan, John Feinstein's new book is about the quarterback, the most important person in the NFL. And then George Washington is still popular for history. So there's two new books about him, Nathaniel Philbrick's The Hurricane's Eye about Yorktown and Valley Forge about that. Now, if you want stocking stuffers, here's two ideas. A Single Spy by William Christie asks the question, can a single person change the course of history? And then The Story of Arthur Truelove by Elizabeth Berg is a small town, wonderful novel. I fell in love with Arthur Truelove.
All right, all those nonfiction books look fantastic. So a whole bunch of options for reading. I'm about to fill up my Kindle. Do people still use Kindles? I don't know.